All right, guys, here we are back again. The Maverick MT rebuild. Not so much a rebuild, we're just basically, like I said before, going over everything. And we've got a new jewel to go into here. So where we're at now, obviously you can see that we're a fair way back along. All the dips are back together. And in the bottom of this front diff, if you remember, had that crack. So I'm getting on to ordering a new diff case for this. So I've put some sealer in there, sealed it all up to keep the water and all the dirt and crap out of there. So front diff's all back together. The steering, like I said before, when we had this little arm down in here. Remember I said one of the bolts got pulled right out. So I've put a longer bolt through, and as you can see, there's a nut on top, and the other side is exactly the same, just for a bit more security. Now, the radio gear, all that back in, righto, it's all in. And there's the little spring and washer that I was talking about when you go to pull it apart, to make sure it goes back in, okay? Your spring and your washer. One other thing too, that I was saying about in the bottoms of these two steering joints here, if you want to call it joints. Now we had, I think the top of this one, the bolt was snapped off, and the bottom of this one, I think. Sorry, other way around. Bottom of this one, because I had got the gouge and the plate there, and the top of this one. Now I had to drill them out. So one, I was able to, if you can focus on that little sucker there, I was able to get that one out. And the other one, if you can see on that little bad boy there, I had to drill him out. Get him out. So that was no mean feat, that little sucker there. But got him out. And we now have new screws in here. This one and the new one in the bottom of that one, down the bottom. So excuse me. So right, you can see it's all back together. Servos are in. They're all still fine, they're all good. Radio box and everything's back in. I still have to get a receiver battery for this. I've cleaned the clutch bell out as good as we can do. Which it come back pretty good. Now, like I said in the other videos, if I spin him round, I said we were gonna have a look at the gears. Now, so here we go. Look at the gears. Now, if you look at them gears, all of them, all four of them, they look brand new still. They still are very, very good. Now, this is another thing too. When I got this truck, this gear drive set up here, the system is all dry. Just like the drive cups on this thing, dry. Now, for something that's dry, I mean, look at them, they're still good. So, check all the grub screws, everything else, all in there, that's all good. We can put the cover back on that, well, now actually, but I will leave that off till later. Not much else to go by here, as everything else is pretty much in place except for, now, I have not yet put this rear brace back on here because I have one of the, I'll grab this here and show you guys. Right, so there's your brace, right? Now that, as you guys know, let me just turn that around, sits in the back there. And remember, there's a little plastic shim that goes under here. Now, I managed to get a broken stud out of the bottom, sorry, not this one, the other one that goes on this side. It's got a broken stud in, so I've got it soaking in some penetrine. Actually, it's supposed to be pretty good stuff, so I will put this on later on, hence why I cannot put these suckers on, which go into here. So they go onto there, bolt through the back with your two bolts into here. And I can't put these on. Well, I probably could, but it's a lot easier to put the back brace I just had, put that in without these on. So I'm going to leave these off for now too. Now, I am still, I still have to yet get some new fuel hose for here. So the tank's back in. I put the tank, only reason the tank's got to go back in, as you know, so the drive shaft can be in here. So hence why that's in. But like I said, I've still got to get some hose for here, which will be good. hopefully the next video. Now, apart from that, oh, also the modifications I had to do for this engine. Look down here. As you can see, I have cut out these panels out of here. So to keep some rigidity in the chassis, I did not cut this all the way down flush with this. I left a little bump there and smoothed it all out, and just to make it look pretty and there's no sharp edges and all that sort of stuff. So in a minute you'll see why that's cut out, and hence the last video I spoke about with, well, the first video, sorry, when we set the motor in here, the pull start sits out here. So that all aside, what we'll do now is we'll get the engine and we'll throw it in. So I'll grab it out. Box. Alrighty, and here she is. The power plant. Alright, so now, as you know, there's two spaces to go on here, which then bolts through from underneath, and then 1, 2, 3 bolts to go in through this side, hence why that cover's not on. Actually, truth be told, I think that cover can still be on. So I think there's cutouts in it for these three bolts anyway. So, but regardless of that, we're going to throw this in now anyway. So all it is, like you see on all the other, most other RC trucks and that, the two holes here, one here. Now, very similar bolt pattern as, well, pretty much the same as the Bajas and all that sort of stuff. So the Lossy MTXL and the Lossy 5T, I'm not too sure if they are the same. Not too sure. Check out on YouTube anyway. There's some other guys that have already done transplant of these into the Lossy 5T and the MTXL. So, but this one, same as the Baja. So it should bolt straight into here, and it already does because I've already tried it. But anyway, so let's go straight into there. Alrighty. So it sits straight in there. Now, like I said, just gonna grab a couple of bolts and we'll throw them in a second. So what I'm gonna do, first of all, dislocate it. I'm gonna put the three bolts in the side. As you can see there, righto. Two of those two, they just bolt straight in, just like that. And one in the bottom, straight into there. Can you see that? There we go, straight in the bottom there. Right up. Do them up. And now, if I grab these two bolts, now this is where it gets a little bit finicky. I'll do one at a time. So I've got to go in under here, put a spacer in there. All right, guys, do these little suckers up. Don't forget to put your spacers in. Now, I did have to do something off camera because, as you can see, I'll just do these up nice and tight. Now, I will have to check these later. Now, what I did find out, though, guys, is nice and tight. Now, I had to, if you come down here, I don't know if it's all that, whether you can see it all that well, these two holes right there, your motor mount bolts, right? Now, on the other side of the plate, there's two spaces that go between the chassis plate and the engine. So they did not quite line up, which I thought they would, but the only thing is you just have to adjust your holes a fraction. So get your drill bit out and just had to move the holes just up out towards the edge, just a touch. So as the two, it's like 2 or 3 mil max. So that's all it is. And they're still, and as you can see, they're still flush mounted. So if you don't go too overboard and you go steady, you'll get it. And they'll still go in the countersunk areas, nice and flush, all right? So keep that in mind when you're fitting these big bad boys. So I'll just go around here and I will do up these three mount bolts on this side. So like I said before, 1, 2, 3 on this side. You go screw straight in around the clutch housing, actually, as a lot of you blokes would know. These three, and voila, motor fitted. Now, as you can see, now the motor's sitting in there, You can see why, and like I was saying in the earlier videos, that this piece had to be cut out. Now look alongside the chassis through here. If you look straight along the side through here, I'll bring that in there. Now you see how far out, oops, sorry guys, you see how far out this sticks. So, well, you got the thickness of your of the edge of your chassis plate, right? So pretty much, it's pretty much only just sits outside the rail. But to get this motor in, you do need to cut this section out. So, but all in all, that fits really nice in there. Doesn't stick out abnormal, whereas the original one, like I said, sits in here on the standard motor. But there you have it. So now, while I say that, if you look into here, like I was saying before, I had to adjust the holes. Now there's your two spacers, one there and one there. Still goes in the same place, you just had to adjust the holes out this way. And like I said, if you don't go silly, just go steady, you may have to put the motor back in, try the holes again, pull it out, adjust them, you will get there. And like I said, if you don't go silly, they still come up nice and flush and it's all good. So minor adjustment. It's not an exact fit, but little tiny adjustment like that and a modification on the side of your chassis here, she's sweet as. So the other thing I had to do, I almost forgot. If you come down here, down to this side, now see where this side bolt hole is here. Now I had to take away, I still haven't cleaned it up yet, it's got crap all in there. Look on the bottom here. Actually, if I can get something to point at it with you. Now if I use my screwdriver, see Danny in this section where I'm tapping there, under there. Now I had to remove that section, if you can just see that, take it away. See how it's all, I had to take that piece off there with enough room. Now if I bring the camera back here, enough room so that when I undo this lid, I got enough room to clear there, so I can lift the lid up, sort of like lift it up and slide it out. That's why I had to remove that section there. Don't want to cut the whole thing off, because who knows, might want to put this motor into something else later on. But so another little modification, so little mod there, just so you can undo your bolt to lift your lid off and still get it out, still clear that and get out, get your battery and all your electronics in here. The other mod with the side plate, the side of your chassis, and slightly adjustment of your two screws here to move the holes over a touch. And you can do that with a drill bit, and just gently bring the drill bit across and not too much, it doesn't need much. And then there you go, she's bolted in. Now, like I said, I am still waiting for me carby and everything else. Currently I'm working on an idea of a still an exhaust, or even a header pipe for that matter, so still working on that. Hopefully I can come to a conclusion with that pretty soon. Still waiting the damn carby. It should have been here already. I don't know what's going on, but I will be contacting the seller, find out what's going on. Now one thing that I did find out, which I was going to mention in the last video, now the carby didn't come on this engine. Right now, when I contacted the seller, I was wanting to know what the reason was for this. Now, because every other engine that I looked at on the internet, you know where I'm looking, all different kinds of places, they all come with a carby. These motors, the Zenawas, the CYs, they all come with carbies, no matter what motor you got. Not sure why, until I spoke to the seller. Now he said to me that he got it from Predator with no carby, right? So, and I thought, well, that's strange, because the motor's useless without a carby. And his response to that was to save on cost. Correct me if I'm wrong, but we're going to be paying more cost now getting this carby because it didn't come with it in the first place. Regardless of the fact, that's my little bitch. But at the end of the day, there she is, motor's installed. Electronics is in. I can't do anything more than that. Like I said, I've got to get some hose, put the fuel filter back in. Everything else is pretty much almost ready to go, except for the rear bumpers, obviously. And this brace that goes in here. Other than that, we're good. So, a couple of little tips there with installing this motor. And like I said on the other videos, I did turn this pull start 180 almost from having the pull start to here, from here to over here. I mean, it's my personal choice. I mean, I'm right-handed, okay? So I'd like to pull it from here. Being a truck with the body like this, it doesn't matter where it is. I just turned that for me for ease of starting. I'm right-handed, so. Anyway, that's long enough, guys. The video's gone long enough. Just an update, see where we're at. Don't forget to hit the like button, guys. Subscribe if you're a new viewer and stick around. We've got some more coming. And the other thing is, we may have a new ride on the show. So keep that in the back of your brain, because I'll be doing a review on a new vehicle, and we'll get to that later on. So till next time, guys, have fun, get outside, get your rigs. Maybe you can do some upgrades. Go and have some fun, guys. I'll see you in the next one.